Swanage TV, Swanage TV. It's just right for you and for me. Have fun in the sun, go swim in the sea. There's always something special on Swanage TV.
Hello, good evening. Welcome to another edition of Swanage TV, episode number 36. Can you believe? It is Friday, the 14th of May. It is 6 p.m. and we are live. Thank you very much for joining us. I'm your host, Ian, and today my co-host, Rosemary, is not here. She's taken a sabbatical and we hope to have her back soon, but she's got some commitments. I think Sky News is in contractual negotiations for her, so we'll see her soon at some point. We are sure. Well, how is everyone? I hope everyone's well. Thanks for joining us. I hope you had a great week or so since the last show. What's happening? Is Boris talking? What's he saying we can and can't do this week? Who knows? We've got a packed show, so stay with us. So I'm going to get straight into it, really. Normally at this point, I'd say, hi, Rosemary, what you've been doing? She'd tell me she'd been on her bike or whatever. But we're going to get straight into it. So I'll start the show with a big hello to this chap. This chap here. Big Dave Taylor. Hello, Dave. It was his birthday yesterday. 73 he was. Looking good for 73. Only joking, Dave. Happy birthday for yesterday. Another shout out, got a message. This is from one of our overseas viewers. We had a message to get in touch. This is from a chap called Mark, who's working out in Bali. He wants to say hello to his son, Riley Girling. Said he'll see you soon. Hope you're well. Good stuff. International we are, fully international. Like to say a big shout out to, actually, the Purbeck School, and of course a few other schools today that did a non-school uniform day to Will Does 2004, the charity. So well done to you, Purbeck, and all, a few other schools took part as well. I think it was 10 in total. So good, yeah, friend of the show, Will Does charity. Very, very good, very worthy cause indeed. Last shout out I've got is, I didn't know this at all. Royal British Legion, 100 years old. Excuse me, 100 years old. So they're celebrating their centenary. So tomorrow, down at the War Memorial, you're going to have at 9 o'clock, you've got the mayor, you've got Steve Churchill, a few other dignitaries there doing a ceremony. 9 o'clock, War Memorial. So be there if you want to join them. Socially distanced, of course. But yeah, happy birthday to the Royal British Legion as well. That's a little bit mad. Now, last thing I want to know is we had a great show last week, last fortnight, thank you, on the last show. We had a really good time and we had some amazing comments and really good good comments for everybody, and they were all, it was very nice. So thank you very much. If you're new to the show, go back and watch some other shows. There've been some funny moments on there. But as we are busy, first thing I'm going to do is find out who else is going to be with us. Wow, dear, oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Hello. It went a bit mad there. Hello, Mark. How are you, sir?
Good evening. I'm here to spice up your life, everybody.
You spiked nearly twice. You nearly all came in then. How are you, Mark?
Very well indeed. Thank you. Yourself, Ian?
Yeah, getting through the week. Getting through the week. Bit difficult. Flying solo tonight without the lovely Rosemary. So it could all go wrong. It already has. So we'll see how we get on. How are things with you, Mark?
Very well indeed. Been fighting for truth and justice all week in my other day job. Planning out my last two matches as Wareham Rangers under-16s coach. Just over a week to go before I become semi-retired.
Very nice indeed. Very nice indeed. So, Mark, where are you right now? It looks like you're at Wareham Bridge again.
I'm down by the river in Wareham at the moment. But later on, Ian, I will be... Can you keep a secret, by the way? Can you keep a secret?
I am very good at secrets.
Good. Well, in that case, I can tell you I will be at Carey's secret garden.
What do you mean?
I can't disclose the location, but I will be giving the viewers a sneak peek and I'm looking forward to it, I have to say.
Excellent. I am also looking forward to that, Mark. Really, really good. So, Mark, how are our friends at Salt Pig? Have they provided us with the necessary something?
Of course they have. Our friends are always good to us. And yet again, they provided us with a £10 voucher to give away to the lucky recipient.
Fantastic. And Mark, well, let me tell you, I'm assuming that lucky recipient could be a random strange member of the public there.
It could well be, and there are none stranger than the members of the public, I have to say. I wonder if we can find anybody that may be willing to answer. I can't call it the $64,000 question, because clearly it's the £10 Salt Pig voucher question. But as I approach the key-in public house...
You're zeroing in on your victims, I can see them.
I am indeed. Well, who is going to be? Remember, this is live TV. I know you've all had a drink. Look, this lady says she's fine. But let's see if she knows the answer to the question to win the Salt Pig voucher.
Okay.
What is the best television company in the world?
Swanage TV.
Yay!
look how excited they are. Excellent. They can hardly control themselves. And do you blame them?
That's fantastic. I love that, Mark. I absolutely love that. Crazy stuff. Mark, do you happen to have any birthdays this week?
Do you know what? It just so happens that I do.
Ooh, now, there's a surprise.
Yes, well. There are two birthday victims this week. The first one being Natalie Thompson. Now,
she's
what can I tell
pretty.
You about not Natalie? Well, now, Natalie was, I think she's getting towards 40 at her own admission. And you can see from the first photo, initial thoughts are, you know, quite a demure, smart, young lady. Smart, young lady. But then we move on to the next photo, and things are starting to unravel slightly. You know, the length some people will go to hold that makeup in place. I mean, what on earth is she wearing there? But it's all about the image, isn't it? But of course, again, I can tell you that I used to be a near neighbour of Natalie. And things fell off. You know, we were quite good terms. But then it came to the point where I had to get a restraining order, because I'd open the curtains. You know, in the morning when you wake up, you pull back the curtains to see what sort of day it is, and I'd be greeted by this. Yes, appalling, appalling. And I mean, I must remind Natalie, the restraining order is still in place at the moment. You know, it's the last thing you need first thing in the morning is that when you open the curtains.
Indeed.
And I think the last photo sadly shows that, I know this is a family show, but you can see she's let herself go a little bit.
You are in so much trouble.
No, Natalie's got a great sense of humour.
Happy birthday, Natalie. I am so sorry. I am so sorry. Well done. Who else, Mark?
Now, the wonderful Ben Smith. He is the proprietor of Big Dreams.
Right.
And I have to say, was most generous.
They give us some really good stuff, Mark, didn't they, for the Christmas
fantastic prizes. But despite his generosity, he doesn't get away with it either. You'll see that when he was younger, with his mate Ricky, Ricky clearly wasn't entering into the spirit of the gurning competition, but clearly Ben was. Put a great deal of effort into that. And I did warn him if the wind changed, his face might stay like that. Been through several guys, says Ben. 80s, bit of a mullet man. Liked his middle-of-the-road American rock. And bless him, he eventually, despite that mullet, found a lovely lady, his wife, Lucy. And I said to Ben on his wedding day, how are you going to get through the day? And he just produced this massive drink. He went, this is how I'm going to get through the day. I think that's how he did it. So many happy returns to you, Ben.
Yes, happy birthday, Ben. I think he got off quite lightly there, to be fair.
I think he did. You know, it could have been a lot worse, but I did take into account as a mitigating factor his generosity for the Christmas bonanza.
Oh, fantastic. Excellent. Mark, okay, we will see you and on very soon. Looking forward to the Secret Garden. I'll see you in a bit.
Wonderful. See you shortly. Bye.
Thanks a lot. Bye-bye. Looking forward to that. Carey's got a secret garden. Are you sure? Looking forward to it. It's a very, very, very good thing. Shall we see who else is about? Shall we see who will be joining us again on this wonderful day? Let's just have a check who's coming through. And it's our lovely Nico. Nico, hello, how are you?
Hi, Ian. I'm so sorry you're on your own tonight. You must be freaking out.
I am. I'm not over-talking, or I hope I'm not yet. Give it time. I might.
No, as long as Rosemary does not sign a long-term Sky contract, hopefully she will be back soon.
Hopefully, hopefully. Nico, how are you? How have you been this week?
Oh, Ian, look behind me.
It's
how am
beautiful.
I'm fabulous, Ian. It's got to be the best view in the world, look.
Absolutely.
And I'm actually outside, look. I'm indoors.
Ooh.
I'm at
camera trickery.
Indeed. I'm at a really historic building in Swanage, perched on the cliffs, and that's the Grand Hotel.
Wow.
I've been given special permission by Lindsay Bish, the manager, to come on in before it opens to the public again, because they've done some amazing work in here, Ian. It is phenomenal. Part of the work has uncovered some really amazing historical artefacts that I'm going to show off you. Yeah.
Oh, I am looking forward to that, Nico. Oh, excellent. What, in the hotel itself, they found some... Wow.
It's in the hotel, and so I'm going to show our viewers. You're going to be the first people to see what they found while they've been doing all the work up here. I mean, it's stunning in there, Ian. It's amazing.
Wow.
It is.
I am looking forward to having a look at all of it, Nico. Thank you, thank you, thank you. We will see you again soon, Nico. See you in a bit.
Indeed.
Bye-bye. Really looking forward to that. Ancient treasures in the hotel. Very interesting. Very, very interesting indeed. Looking forward to that. Shall we see if we've got... shall we see who else is on? Let's have a look. Let's see where we are with everyone. Let's have a look. Let's see if our New York correspondent's coming. I don't know. And there you go, our Englishman in New York. Hello to you, Ryan. How are you, sir?
I'm very well, Ian. Thank you very much. Hello, reviewers. How are you this evening?
We're well, thank you, Ryan. Ryan, where are you?
Well, I got caught out not being able to say hello to Rosemary, of course, and make fun of Brucey. But anyway, where I am tonight, and where this, it's afternoon here, of course, is if I just turn around and I can show you, I'm at the 9/11 Memorial Park.
Wow.
And behind me is the site of the North Tower, which has been converted into a pool. And all around the edge, you'll see there are a lot of names inscribed of the people who unfortunately perished in that disaster.
Wow.
Which resonates with a lot of us, I'm sure.
Yes, indeed. Wow, Ryan, that's some monument.
Absolutely. And of course, the whole area has been renovated. And again, if I just turn around, behind me is the One World Tower. It's called the Freedom Tower. I don't know if you can see the extent of how high that is.
Yeah,
coming
very
from Swanage, we're not used to big buildings, are we?
Not that big.
Small blocks of flats at best, you know, but here, I mean, we are dwarfed. If I do a forward view, you can see the oculus right opposite me. But downstairs, underneath there, is where you arrive into this part of Manhattan. I'm on the PATH train from Hoboken. And again, I'll just show you where the names are, and you see a rose there. And the Memorial Park staff, they will put a rose against the name of one of the victims when it's their birthday.
I'm
going to be walking around here. Come back to me. I'll be showing you the name of somebody that has had a very strong link to Swanage, and his family still do.
Excellent. Ryan, that's fantastic. Really looking forward to that. Wow, what a somber place. What a somber type place, you know?
Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. Very thought-provoking, very emotional when you consider the number of lives lost here. And the extent of this, I mean, the size of it is just incomprehensible when you just stood here looking at it. You don't realize, you know, how, when you see the ones next door and what you're looking at here in this pool, you know, that was a building of equal size that came down. And across the way is the South Tower site, exactly the same format with a pool like this. Wow. And the pool is quite impressive, you know, and it's very, very interesting design. I believe it's a Japanese guy that designed it, but, you know, we're going down our hill there. It's quite an amazing sight.
Interesting stuff, Ryan. Interesting, my friend. I'm looking forward to coming back and having a look. Maybe we can have a chat with someone as you're going, if they're up for it. But for now, I'm going to leave you to it, Ryan. And thanks very much for that. We will see you in a bit. Yes, excellent. Cheers, Ryan.
Absolutely.
See you soon. Bye-bye.
Thanks.
Wow, that's a bit good, isn't it? That's a bit somber. It'd be nice to, you know, take a bit of moment on reflection, perhaps, on some of that. So, yeah, looking forward to that. Hopefully you'll be there soon. Now, there is a rumour, and it's only a rumour, that we've got the one and only Housewives favourite in tonight. And you know what? I know I can see him. I know I can see him. So this is a good thing. Ladies and gentlemen, please say hello to the one and only Gary D. Gary, hello. How are you?
Hi, Kevin. Do you know how much trouble I've had trying to get on to it? It's unbelievable. Right?
Technology's not your friend today, is it?
No, it's like to the last second, wasn't it?
Indeed it was. But I'm glad you're with us, Gary. I'm glad you're in the Swanage TV kitchen. What are you going to be rustling up for us later on, mate?
Today, it's going to be a cod in a wine and parsley sauce.
Ooh, lovely. Really looking forward to that. It's
either chicken or cod, isn't it?
Chicken or fish, it doesn't matter. Anything you like, as long as it's chicken or fish.
That's the dish.
But you know what? Cod in parsley sauce, Gary, is one of my all-time favourites. So really looking forward to that, matey. Thanks very much. I'm glad you're back with us, mate.
It's helpful.
I'll see you soon, mate. Thanks a lot, Gary. Take care. Cod in parsley sauce. I'm starving already. I mean, I'm properly hungry. So we got full house tonight. So everybody's on board. Could be a long show, you never know. Now, what we are going to do is have a quick look around the town. Let's have a look. Let's see who's on the... Oh, boat's docked. What's he bringing in? Fish? Don't know. Looks lovely, though. Still looks lovely. Very, very nice indeed. Let's have a little see from the other ones. If the satellite's in place, we can look at the ship of doom. And there it is. Oh, look at that. That's fantastic. Beautiful, beautiful place we live, isn't it? Let's go and look at the prettiest railway station in the world. Look at that. Beautiful stuff. And of course, the best railway station in the world, which had extra deer on in the week, didn't it? Did you see that on the banks there? It had a deer. Very, very nice. Very strange. Hope it got there safely. Excellent. We're going to run the weather quick because that's been a nightmare. Let's have a look at the weather. What have we got tonight? Raining. Tomorrow, rain and sun. Sunday, rain and sun. Monday, rain and sun. Tuesday's brightening up. Wednesday's getting better. Probably good for the back end of next week. So there you go. What are we going to do now? I'll tell you what we're going to do now. We're going to be back after this.
Hello, my name's Jane Clark and I run Bugbusters Pest Control. Heard noises in the loft? Or are the wasps around your barbecue spoiling the fun? Pick up the phone and call Bugbusters Pest Control. Check out my website and read my excellent reviews. I'm local to you, so call Bugbusters Pest Control. 01929 460011. I know about pests.
You're okay. and welcome to Birkbeck Whole Foods. We're a traditional, friendly, independent store. Pop in and see us in North Street, Wareham, and take a look around. Or call us on 552 332 to place an order. And if you want us to, we can even deliver to your door.
There you go. Welcome back. Did you see the size of that bit of fish? Did you? Oh, I am starving now. I am very, very hungry. Now, it's that time. I've got to skip through the my favourite part of the show. Five Hot Topics of the Week. Sing along. And hot topic number one. This is insane. This is insane. Hot topic number one is, in actual fact, thefts of catalytic converters, which is utterly bizarre. They're stealing parts of cars now, not all of them. So the Purbeck police are warning that vehicles in Swanage are currently being targeted by catalytic converter thieves. I think they sell, you know, that people are buying them. They're easy to do. You know, the latest incidents happened overnight between Tuesday the 4th and Wednesday the 5th of May in North Swanage. Thefts of catalytic converters occurred overnight in the Bay Crescent and the Redcliffe Road area of Swanage. Police are continuing to make inquiries, etc. But be on your lookout for these people, because they target certain cars. Priuses, I know they target Priuses and a few other things. So if you've got a catalytic converter, keep an eye out. There are thieves about, the swines. There you go. Hot topic number two coming up. And there it is. Hot topic number two is, this I thought was, again, quite bizarre, only in the fact that every summer we have a nightmare when it gets really busy, and the last two summers when lockdowns happen and they're lifted and we get massive numbers, Studland is having a new tow-away zone, so be careful. It's going to be introduced along the ferry road in Studland to help prevent a repeat of last year's chaos, as you can see there. Both sides parked, you couldn't get anything through the buses. If an ambulance needed to get there, it was going to be a disaster. So it will mean Dorset Council will have the power to remove any illegally parked vehicle and take it away to a compound. And they won't muck about. They will not muck about. They'll take them all. So just be careful. They couldn't issue a fine in the past. You know, they could issue a fine, but it didn't help keep the roads clear. They didn't care. So the removal of the cars is going to be one of the things. So there you go. Pay attention. Now, this is a very, very controversial subject. It's the Ship of Doom. There's been loads of chatter, loads of sort of anger and a bit of resentment on the social media. £4.75 it's gone up to. It's a 25% increase. You know, it's gone up. But the thing is, now it's getting to the point where it's almost cheaper to go in the car round, which doesn't help the carbon, doesn't help anything. And I don't think the Swanage Ferry Company are doing it. You know, they're interested in the holiday people. It's good stuff. You can still get, if you're a local, you can still prepay and get your tickets as you normally can, but it's going up. But if it keeps going up, is it going to become economically unviable for the locals to use it? I don't know. I don't know. But it's gone up from Monday the 17th of May. Following a decision by the Secretary of State for Transport, Grant Shapps, to accept the recommendation of the inspector to allow the ferry company to increase the prices, and fares will rise, as we've said before, over the next 10 years, where it will be £6.75 by 2031. Cyclists, though, been frozen at £1, and pedestrians as £1. So there you go, one good thing about it. So there you go, thank you very much. Happy days. Now, number four, hot topic number four is, in actual fact, Star Wars is in the Purbeck. I am your father, Luke. I'm not, obviously, but there you go. At Winspit, yes. Now, Winspit, derelict quarry, is being used for location. It has been for ages. There's been other stuff like Doctor Who, Blake 7, remember that? Remember Blake 7? Quality programme. And a few other things. And more recently, a Disney film, John Carter. So this is up at Winspit. You can look over and have a look at what they're doing as well, because it's all public and everything. Now, their filming is for this project called Andor. It's a 12-episode Star Wars series for Disney. It's about the formation of the rebellion. So if you're a Star Wars guy, you will probably love it. But there you go. Yeah, isn't it good? We've had loads of stuff come because it's the best place in the world. Even Disney come here. So there you go. If you want to go up and have a look, you can. Now, got to get through this one quick. The fifth and final hot topic is the Trevor Chadwick Memorial has been released. The little statue there that we've been looking at. Now, it's a first glimpse. I think you see it there. I don't know if you can make it out. It's the Trevor Chadwick will look like when it's installed in its location on the Swanage seafront next to the bandstand. And we'll talk a little bit more about that in a minute. Where we've got the lovely Karen Grant coming on. So we'll have a little chat to her. Now, Trevor Chadwick, you may or may not know, he was a Swanage teacher. He's an RNLI volunteer. He's being recognised for risking his life back in 1939, rescuing the children of Prague from the German occupation. He moved to Swanage in 1928, where his father set up the Forest School in Northbrook Road. Ooh, now the Purbeck View School. He worked there as a Latin teacher, and in early 1939, Trevor Chadwick became one of only a handful of mainly British volunteers who rescued those children out of Prague. So fair play to him, you get your statue. And I think it's fully deserved. So well done, Trevor Chadwick. I used to know one of his relatives, Mr. Chadwick. He used to come into the shop. Lovely man, lovely, lovely man. But to tell us a little bit more about this Trevor Chadwick and someone, our lovely Karen Grant, is going to be doing something. I'll tell you what, we'll just call her. We'll have a look. We'll give her a shout. If it works, because I'm on my own, as you know, we can see. Let's have a look. Hold on. It may work, but I have to do a couple of things. We shall see. We shall see. Karen, are you there?
I am.
Yay! Third time lucky. Yay. Well done. So the lovely Karen Grant, welcome to the show. You finally made it. We're pleased to have you on. Goodness me.
Thank you.
Karen, what's happening then? Yeah. Tell us about this wonderful concert that you're doing. Because you've been doing everything. Just before we go, you've been doing everything on a Saturday all through lockdown. All of the gigs you've done for everyone, and I'm sure loads of people have found it a lovely comfort and something to watch on a Saturday other than the repeats on the telly.
Well, you're too kindy, and I don't know about a lovely comfort, but for me, just keeping the old vocal cords going has been pretty important, as the old sort of mindset, because it's just been such a crazy time for everybody. It's unimaginable what
Indeed.
We've been through,
and
now we're now we're coming through sort of the other side of it. In fact, I'm sat outside a pub because obviously, as I said, you can't get a good mobile phone signal where we are, and I'm just thinking, as from next Monday, people can not only sit outside, but they'll be able to go inside as well.
Absolutely, you can get out of the rain.
Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah, it's good.
It's been awful, isn't it, the weather?
Yeah, not the best thing, Karen, at all, really. But look,
no.
Karen, you're a singer, you're an entertainer, and you are doing something, celebrating this freedom, celebrating the Trevor Chadwick Memorial Trust. What is it you're going to be doing, Karen?
Yeah, OK. So, obviously, it's a massive fundraiser for a wonderful unsung hero who has been found out to be the sort of equivalent of what Schindler was. He apparently managed to evacuate 669 children from Nazi Germany to obviously better places in their world. And so a memorial trust has been set up to raise money for a wonderful statue that Moira Purver is in the throes of making.
Yes, and we've just seen it up next to the bandstand. It's going to be a fantastic thing.
It really is, and it is so fitting, the look of it. It just looks incredible. And, of course, the new Trevor Chadwick playground, which will be open on the day of this concert. So from on Saturday, the 26th of June, at the bandstand from 4 p.m. till 10 p.m.
Oh, it's a late one.
Oh, yeah. late-ish, but hopefully, obviously, you know, it won't just finish dead on 10, but obviously as near as we can. But it's just going to be a wonderful late afternoon to the end of an evening for various people who are going to perform. We've got Dune Ranger School of Dance. We've got the wonderful girls and boys from Swanage School, the drama department.
Lovely.
They're going to open. Yeah, they're going to open the concert. There's going to be a lovely group called All Sorted, another group of girls and boys. There's going to be the Wareham, members of the Wareham Town Band. It'll be scaled down because of not being able for all of them to get together to practice. They're going to be playing. There's going to be the Salamander Swing Band.
Wow.
There's going to be, yeah, Phoenix Rock and Roll Group Band, which will end the evening. There's a guitar, acoustic guitarist and singer called Tranquility. So it's, and there's going to be, excuse me, there's going to be alcohol and cream teas being
served. I can see that. I can see it says there's going to be a bar and cream teas available. So, looking forward to that.
That's being supplied by the wonderful Julian Wood from Swanage Country.
Love him. We love Julian.
Health shop. Everybody knows Julian and his lovely wife, Lucy. So it pertains to be an absolutely cracking day. Obviously, one thing is going to be the weather, which none of us have control over. So we just hope and pray that we get fabulous weather in June. And it's also Armed Forces Day on that day.
Oh, okay.
So, so we're sort of hoping, I'm in contact, hopefully, with Frank Roberts. We might get some lovely armed members of the armed forces wandering around. Linda Welsh and her group of marshals will be marshalling to collect, have buckets so people can throw in all their money.
Lovely.
And obviously, because we haven't got a carnival this year, I'm hoping that it'll go some way to obviously getting the whole town, you know, together and locals. And obviously there'll be hopefully many, many holiday makers.
Lovely. Karen, do you know what? I think it'll be a hit. I really do. I think it'll be something that the town can get behind. It'll be great. It'll be a good thing. And it's at the bandstand. It's at the bandstand. That's what it's supposed to be for. Let's use it for what it is.
The dear old bandstand, which Alan Houghton, you know, it was christened back in October 2019 on a horrific day with weather, if you remember rightly. It was awful.
Well, I should have...
500 people turned out.
They did, 500 people. Yeah, it was a lot. I think 26th of June, I reckon you're going to be okay for the weather, Karen. I really do.
I do hope so. I hope so, Ian. Perhaps if you've got a direct line with him upstairs, you could do something.
Sadly, I haven't. But some people I know, they think they have, so I'll give them a shout. All right. But listen, Karen, for now, thank you. We will, if we have you, we may have you on before that date. But if not, we will come and see you and support you on the 26th of June.
And all the other boys and girls. Yeah.
Lovely. And the bandstand, it will be great.
It will be. Ian, can I just very quickly say a massive, massive thank you to Amanda Jensen, who is the, she's set up the Salamander Swing Band, but she's also doing all the horrific paperwork for all the risk assessments for the concert.
Yes, yes. I can only imagine what a nightmare that will be.
Just a bit. Anyway, lots of love to you all. Thank you, Ian and Rosemary and everybody on Swanage TV.
Oh, thank you, Karen. We like to see you soon. And obviously we'll see you soon and hear you soon back on that radio.
Yep. Perfect. Thank you, guys.
Karen, thanks very much. Bye-bye now.
Bye.
Wow, there you go. What about that? What about that then? What about that? You can't knock that. That was pretty good. Be there 26th of June. That should be a great, great day. Now. Let's see what we're going to do now. We don't know what we're going to do now. it's gone mad. I need Rosemary. We'll be back after this.
Hello, in town early in the morning and you're feeling a bit peckish, the best thing to do is come to the High Street Cafe for brilliant breakfast, cracking coffees and sumptuous snacks. As you can see, we're all COVID ready and happy to serve you. If you're in town early in the morning and you're feeling a bit peckish, the best thing to do is come to the High Street Cafe for brilliant breakfast, cracking coffees and sumptuous snacks. As you can see, we're all COVID ready and happy to serve you.
And serve you twice. He's there twice. Technical issues. What can we do? What can we do now? It's come that time where I'm going to try to get our good friend Tigger, but we're having a few issues here with our stream, so I haven't got him. Strangely, I wonder if he needs to go back out and come back in, which is a real shame because I might now have to go the other place. Let me just see what I can do here. Hold on, bear with me everyone, please. And I'm sure we'll perhaps he could rejoin the call. Let's see what happened. We've got a little bit of an issue, but we'll try. Don't worry, we'll try. We'll be there. We'll sort it out. We'll see. Bear with me. And hopefully we will have the wonder that is Mark Tigrigby, our ninja, ginger ninja from Wareham. Or not. It's a technical thing. We're not sure. We may have to go. Very, very strange. Very, very strange what is happening to me here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to have to come back and I'm going to have to go somewhere else. And we're going to have to go live now to our friend Nico. Sadly, we can't get Mark right now, so we're going to go straight across live to Nico. Nico, how are you?
Oh, I'm fantastic, Ian.
Yeah, perfectly.
Are we all good, Ian?
Can well, we, sort, we sort of are. I think I'm having technical issues, as of course you'd expect, with no Rosemary here to guide me, as it were. So for now, Nico... tell us what you've got. What's happening there?
Okay, hand over to us, Ian, and we will all be fabulous from here on in, and you focus on your techno stuff. I'm here with Lindsay Bish, who is the general manager.
Hello, good evening.
Lindsay invited me up because, obviously, like everywhere, the Grand has been shut for quite some time, haven't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, an age.
An
it
age.
This last lockdown feels... like 6 months.
It's been hideous.
It's been
we did a proper studio test yesterday and it's absolutely
but
fine.
Is, I think Mark needs to mute a little bit. Can we hear Mark there?
I can sort of hear Mark on a loopback feed. I don't know where yeah. I'm trying to cut him.
He's
sorry.
Right, we will carry on. As you can see, I'm indoors now with Lindsay. I've got the piano behind me, should we feel like playing
oh,
tunes.
Yes.
But if we jump up, we're going to go pretty slow because of the signal. I'm going to follow Lindsay round towards the front door. So you keep going, Lindsay. There we go. Yep, we can. Now,
I just wanted to explain, if I can, first of all. So what we've been doing, probably like everybody else, has taken the opportunity to thinking time. What can we do? Well, we can do a lot, but what could we afford? Probably not a lot. So... you know, we've painted, we've been decorating, and we've really thought about how to, you know, bring the Grand back again.
How old
it grand.
How old is it, Lindsay?
123 years, so 1898.
Wow.
Built originally as a hotel, funny
yeah.
enough.
Yeah. I mean, it is stunning. Now, just yes. over your head there and behind you.
Right, that's what I'm going to explain.
Yeah, there's some
so
details going
we,
on.
We did. So, you know, myself and I'm going to... mention a name because Rob Marshall was my leisure centre manager. He's been here for about 30 years. And what I hadn't realised was, and I clearly you're going to see his skills, is he's actually got a master's in fine art and he's been amazing. I've said, could you? He said, done. Just
so,
done it.
So let hang on, Lindsay. So instead of for this immensely important historical building, you've discovered that your 30-year leisure centre manager
has great skills.
And he's qualified, amazing. Isn't he? He's got a degree in fine art.
Absolutely amazing.
So take us behind you.
Yeah, so what we thought, okay, we will decorate, but somebody had mentioned about a mosaic floor.
Yeah.
Some dolphin. So I thought, well, let's rip some of the carpet back. As we ripped it back, Rob said, this is no way a dolphin mosaic floor, but you've got an original floor, Victorian floor. So we carried on ripping it back. Well, we'd gone past the point of no return. There's no way that carpet was going to go back. And we've unearthed a beautiful floor. So
let's
go and have a look. We went there with pan up at the stick to the floor.
Now, studio, no one else has seen this. This is like really important stuff.
Ooh.
So this is found under the carpet. Now, this is no small mosaic, is it, Lindsay?
No.
Now,
no.
Was it like this, complete and perfect, when you dug the...
Because if you can imagine, this part here was the original door to the building.
Yeah.
So of tiles here and here.
Yep.
And then we had the tiling going back slightly underneath the oak.
Yeah.
And so again, I said, gosh, we need to restore that. To which Rob said, I can do that. Painstakingly took the tiles up, one by one cleaned them and restored. And you wouldn't even know.
No, I mean, it's honestly, you probably can't see it as clearly as I'd like you to, Ian. But it's absolutely stunning. And I imagine it was probably put in when the hotel was first built.
Oh, yes,
built,
exactly.
It? Yeah.
But we're trying
beautiful.
On that. So if anybody knows anything, please do message me or get hold of Nico.
On that note, the last time I was up here properly was with Wes Mullin, who came over from America, who was the GI who'd come here when it was a mess hall.
Yes.
Back in the Second World War before they were shipped off.
Yes.
So any compatriots of Wes watching, you might have noticed this mosaic floor maybe back then.
Yes.
Who knows? Get in touch.
Yes, please.
What else
Thank
is
you
good?
Very much. So then we said, okay, that's great restoring that. So what's above it?
Uh-huh.
There was a false ceiling. So voila, we uncovered this beautiful Victorian window, well, glass, if you like.
Yep.
And then unearthed the ceiling, which looks nothing like that.
Oh, look. Up here we've
got... It was all lath and plaster ceiling with chunks of this lovely architrave all missing. And how on earth are we going to restore that? To which Rob said, I can do that. And he went up in the void spaces in some of my loft and found the exact piece. But he had to bring it down in chunks because it's so heavy. They literally built it up in a Victorian age, so it weighed a ton. But you wouldn't know which bit he's put back.
No. It's stunning.
Oh, it's stunning. And then he did all the gold leaf around the top.
So he's leafed it as well as restoring it.
As well as restoring it. And then, of course, here we had chunks. This is the original door front here.
Yeah.
We had chunks missing. So again, painstakingly, he's built this up. And tomorrow we do the finishing touches and paint that. So
just amazing.
So we then thought, well, we don't want to put any more carpet down. We can't put carpet next to a lovely floor. We need porcelain tile.
Yep.
So that's what we've done.
So if we follow Lindsay around,
we pulled the carpet up and we made a beautiful porcelain tile floor.
I mean, this is not the grand hotel that many locals will recognise, is it?
It's different.
It's hugely different.
Yes,
and we were chatting before, Ian, and I was saying that I think between Lindsay and Rob, they've got a whole new career ahead of them as fully qualified fine art restorers and interior designers. So let's walk through here, Lindsay.
Exactly. So we laid the floor. So a huge thank you to UK Tiles Direct. We've used them before in Wareham.
Lovely locals.
Fabulous team.
Yes. Yeah. Who else have you worked with locally?
Yes, and then the carpet was all supplied by Swanage Carpet and Curtains, tearing their hair out because everybody wants them.
Yeah.
And we needed them. It took 2 weeks for them to lay. So we've laid this wonderful carpet. We felt in keeping with a Victorian era, and we also wanted to bring the staircase back. We didn't want to carpet wall to wall, not this piece. So we put a runner, we paid to have the runner. We're just waiting for the beautiful bars to come in, just to finish it off.
It's just
a fabulous staircase. And, you know, again, we needed to paint all the walls. We were heavily clad in stripy wallpaper before.
Yeah.
To which, again, Rob said, I can get up there. So he did. He showcased a wonderful, beautiful stained glass window, which is...
It's phenomenal.
It's given a whole new space to this area.
Now let's walk through here, Lindsay,
towards the view.
So, and we'll talk about what you're going to be doing next week. We're
opening up on Monday. We can't wait. It's all very well having something that looks lovely, but we need soul. We need people, you know, to come in and enjoy. So we've invested in some infrastructure as well. So we will go live. It's in place, but we'll go live with that probably, to be fair, end of June.
Yeah.
What that will mean is there'll be QR codes on the table, which means that you can order on your phone through an app, order your food, pay for it.
That's perfect warning as well, because I happen to know the Banks Arms in Studland has enacted an app system where you can't use cash or cards.
Ah.
And we were there last week with a large group of people who'd paid an enormous amount for parking, didn't have a smartphone, and were unable
to
purchase
or
buy. So
No. So we're not saying it's not cash. We're taking all mediums.
Options. Brilliant.
Absolutely. It's an option to use it. If you still want to come up to the bar, you can.
Now, what are you doing? I mean, for people who haven't been here, it's not just a hotel, is it?
No, it's not. And there's a bit of a stigma with hotels. I've always felt that, you know. So we say, do you want to come up casually dressed? Fine. If you want to come up smartly dressed, fine.
Now, would that
there
be,
shouldn't be a problem.
Would that be for a drink or for a meal or lunch?
So we're in the conservatory at the moment. So this is, we class this as a bistro. So we've got 40 covers in here.
It's stunning, Ian.
It looks really beautiful.
I mean, I can't tell you how much work they've done.
Yeah,
so
are you got all the herb pots on the
back. I mean, look at this. Are you doing like lunches from next week, Lindsay?
So, yes, we do.
Yeah.
So we open on Monday, but it'll be Monday lunchtime.
Yeah.
So that'll be for bar lunches. You'll be able to view online. We're putting all our menus up there, so you'll be able to look. You do need to book.
Now let's. Very you mentioned busy. Bar, so before we finish off, I'm going to follow Lindsay round to the bar, Ian, which is something else they've been working really hard on.
We did. So we needed to bring our bar back into a Victorian era, but with a contemporary twist, if you like. So we knocked the colour out on the bar, which used to be a kind of rusty mahogany colour, if you like, and we brought it in with the ebony, so it blends in beautifully with the staircase. And then we put all the big mirrors on the back, and again then I decided it needed a bit of bling but tastefully done. So I wanted some gold, beautiful gold lines painted in here at the back of the bar, and to which Rob said I can do that. He's done. But, you know, I've got a young team at the Grand, but they're phenomenal, all of them, without exception. And you can't be the head of something without a great team behind you. So for me, huge thank you to my team.
Oh,
they've been great.
It's phenomenal.
And they're all looking forward to coming back. So I'm just going to quickly take you through here.
Let's just turn around. We're going to walk through this.
Lovely.
Ian.
Lovely.
We're going to go. Ian. It's honestly, it's so light and airy here.
Yeah.
It's just stunning.
This is through to the cocktail lounge, and we'll start pushing those out. Again, my young bar manager, I'm going to give him carte blanche to come up with his cocktail, and we'll be promoting that shortly. So come through. So we've got the chandeliers here. This is...
look.
Can you see that?
Yeah, it's it's so, so different, Ian. It's like unbelievable. It's
it
so
looks lovely.
Done. It is. It's really, really coming on. Let me just spin you round again and we'll just head down with Lindsay.
And then, so, cocktail lounge here. So, if you want to come and have a little light drink beforehand or a cocktail.
Oh, yes, please.
Again, just a bar snack. Great view. Oh, great vista. And then, of course, we've got 120 cover restaurants. You have functions, weddings, you name
functions.
It.
Functions. Yes, please.
Yes. We all want to hug. Get back to hugging.
Don't we ever?
That's what we do well. Yeah. So I'll just bring you quickly to here. So again, breakfast is served here, but this is where most of the wedding breakfasts take place and our large functions. Christmas, New Year parties for us are huge. Fabulous. Christmas parties, if you haven't booked, get in.
Well, we're going to have to, Lindsay. We've all got to get back to going out and doing things again, haven't we?
And the other thing that we haven't seen, we probably haven't got time to do, but we've walked the whole length of the restaurant and into the main lounge area. So directly underneath, I also have a leisure centre. So we've got swimming pool, jacuzzi, huge gym.
Who is that leisure centre run by, Lindsay?
Rob.
The best leisure centre, art restorer, interior designer in the world.
trainer. He's absolutely super. So
is the gym open, Lindsay?
It is. It right. is. So, you know, at the moment, members have been using or going round to via the garden. But as of Monday, everyone back through the front door.
Monday, life burns.
So we're really pleased to say, you know, pick up the phone, come and book, come and see us.
Phone number?
01929-423353.
Been the same for 30 years, I know that.
I'm not going to change that one.
No. So there you go, Ian and viewers. You can come up for cocktails, lunch, afternoon tea,
yes.
dinners. You don't have to stay the night, but I would probably recommend it because it's stunning.
Lovely. Yeah,
and the gardens, you know, we've increased that. It's about an 80-cover garden.
It's honestly, if you haven't been up, in a while, come up when they open.
Yeah, come and say hello to the team. Yeah. Just relax.
Fantastic. Absolutely. We will. I'm coming up on Monday. Right.
So thank you so much for the opportunity to share this with you.
Thanks very much. You're very welcome.
Oh, well. And I'd like to thank Lindsay for letting me in because it is still closed and they've done a lot of cleaning work today to get it ready.
Lovely.
But support. This place is local. It's been here for years. Support it with your feet. And come up and pay it a visit and spend a bit of money.
One last look at the view.
Right, Lindsay's insisting we have to go shoot down here and we'll do one quick last look at the view.
I think so.
Sign off. I think so.
Wow.
Oh, look. It's just, it's breathtaking. It really is now. It's stunning. There we go. Best town in the world. Best hotel manager in the world. In the best hotel in the world, Ian. What more could you want?
I think that's a hat trick there. Well done to everyone involved. And I hope it really, really goes well from Nico. Great stuff. Great stuff.
Thank you.
All right, Ian, we shall hand back to you and have a great rest of show. We'll be watching.
Nico, thanks very much indeed. I'll see you soon.
Bye.
Bye. Wow, what about that? What about that? I'm going there. I'm definitely going there for a drink now. Now, we've had a few problems. We've got a few problems in the fact that we have a few problems technically. Now, I'm going to try and pull it all back very, very quickly, but it could be a disaster. We're not sure. So bear with us all, okay? Let's see where we are with it all. I've got to try and get everybody back, which is becoming a bit of a nightmare for me. Let's just see if I can get Mark at all. No, here is Mark. We can hear him, I think. We cannot see him. Mark, are you there?
I am indeed, Ian, yes.
Mark, well, sadly, on my screen, it's showing you as a blue square. You are not videoing at all. I don't know what it's like live, sadly. I don't know if it's appearing on the actual thing, so perhaps someone could tell me immediately if that's what's happening.
Well, if it helps, Ian, I can hear you and I can see Ryan in New York.
Oh, Mark, you've come back. Don't worry, you've come back very small. Well, hold on. Hold
when
on.
I told you this is a secret.
You're back,
location,
Mark. You're back. Hello. Sorry about that, and sorry to your guests there, Mark. I know you were going to be on a bit earlier, but honestly,
not to worry.
The
Not
technical stuff is killing me here. So tell me where you are, Mark. This is what I've been looking forward to.
It's a secret location, and that's how secret it is. There's only intermittent signal allowed. Now, I'm not going to walk around, which is a shame, because I'm in a beautiful garden, and it's called Carey's Secret Garden. It's in the grounds or in the vicinity of Carey Woods, but I'll say no more than that. And I have here with me the owner, Simon.
How you doing?
Good evening to you, Simon.
Good evening.
Now, let's get you on, Simon. Here we go. There he is.
Brilliant.
Now, Simon, tell us about yourself. You're the owner of this wonderful place?
Yeah, I think, so my parents have bought a wider estate, and I've been part of this incredible project for the last sort of 18 months,
Fantastic.
Nearly 2 years.
Now, when this was purchased, was this lovely garden, was it here all set up and ready to go or what?
Not really. In fact,
not really.
The spirit of the secret garden was kind of quite evident. All the gates were locked. The walls, actually, you couldn't see the walls.
Overgrown.
Very overgrown.
Wow.
We didn't even really know that it was part of the estate, if I'm honest.
So you were basically unaware that this existed when purchased.
Yeah, it was only afterwards we were poking around and looking through and thinking, hang on a sec, something's here.
Yeah. So, were you surprised to find this?
Yeah, I mean, the surprise just continues, to be honest. It's quite an incredible sight. Yeah, it is. Yeah, but as we revealed the walls, definitely the scale of everything was quite incredible.
You said it was all overgrown, all undergrowth and...
Yeah, we think that, I mean, it goes back to sort of 1880s when it was built.
Wow.
But we think that sort of gradually over the last 30, 40 years, hadn't really been used for too much.
Yeah.
It was sort of a grassy paddock with some trees in. And it was actually my kids who managed to sort of squeeze in.
Right,
so it was a proper classic thing. So
after discovering it, what were your initial thoughts? And you know, who came up with the idea that, you know, we can really make something of this?
My background is I'm a perfumer, which is kind of a slightly odd profession. I've always been interested in plants and kind of aromatic plants and all that.
I see, yes.
Very interested in, I also worked in ethical buying, so interested in sort of sustainability and kind of that. So those things sort of came together a little bit. And then I just thought, this is the perfect spot. You can't really, when you look at something as incredible as this, you can't let it go to rack and ruin, really. So, yeah.
Indeed. Now, if I just pan around, I hope the viewers can see in the distance, there's a wonderful water feature and sculpture. Tell us a little bit about this sculpture.
Well, it's a local sculptor called Ted Edley, and he's created it out of copper, so he's a copperfish.
He's a friend of the show, is Ted, so we know a little bit about him.
So you know him. You know he's got that fabulous mohawk.
Indeed.
And over the last little bit of time, I've sort of called him a bit of a media tart because he's obviously now he's a bit famous, isn't he?
He is, yes. He's not just on Swanage TV. He's on other TV stations.
Obviously this is his prime.
Oh, of course, indeed.
So he basically, we were playing with this concept, actually. I've got background from Lush Cosmetics. So we're playing with this concept of a sort of bath bomb shape that he then took, elongated and played with it. And then came up with this incredible sort of organic kind of feel.
Yes.
It's actually more seed-like. And and he had a lot of fun, I think, in kind of playing.
Well, I think he did, Simon, because I did speak to Ted last night, in fact. And he told me a little bit about how he wanted the sculpture to evolve, etc. And the idea for the colours and how it will change.
Yeah.
As I think it's made of copper, you said, isn't it?
That's right.
Exactly, yes.
Yeah.
So, well, we'll say a big hello to Ted.
Yeah.
Now, if I just turn around, we've got this lovely little sort of building here. And I think our viewers can see, more friends of the show, the secret salt pig. So, again, Simon, tell us what are the salt pig doing here?
Well, we're really lucky, actually, to have a partnership with them. So we've opened just last week for public visitors, and we thought you can't really have a garden without having a cup of tea and a little sit down. So actually knew James quite well from the Salt Pig and came up with this slightly harebrained scheme of putting them in what is actually an old potato store.
Oh, I see.
there's a building built into the walls, not overly big, but just enough to fit a coffee machine and cake and some quiches. So they very kindly have kind of gone with the craziness and have, so when you do arrive, you are able to get some nice refreshments.
Wonderful.
And nowhere better than the Salt Pig.
Absolutely. We totally agree with that, wouldn't we, Ian?
Oh, indeed, yeah. I'm my mouth's watering now. I'm starving.
Yes, I'm sure. Now, Simon, tell us, what's the sort of ethos here? I know, looking at some of the plant pots, they're not your standard plant pots.
Yeah. Yeah, so we've been actually paying quite close attention. Like I said, I'm really interested in sort of sustainability. So it's a little experiment we've been running with the gardeners on a zero-waste plant pot. So it's cardboard, and you have a little lollipop stick that's etched with Carey's Secret Garden in the name. And so when you leave with these plants, they're all cuttings that have grown on site, peat-free compost, and you can just bung it straight into the ground, and it's nice and healthy.
Fantastic. Any sort of plans for events here in the future?
I think once we get this sort of COVID thing under our belts, we'd definitely love to be able to open for events. And this, between now and August, we're actually shut during the month of August, but before then, we're just open for visitors. We may dabble with a couple of events, and then we hope from September onwards we'll be able to bring sort of wider courses and events.
Fantastic.
Programs as
and
well.
Just so the viewers know, how can people come here and visit? What's the procedure?
So we don't actually advertise where we are. You have to book via our website, and then we'll tell you the secret location. It's at careysecretgarden.co.uk. And you can book via there. We are limiting the visitors so that we also have to monitor the impact on the natural world.
Part of course,
the benefit of this beautiful place is bird singing and all that. So there's limited spots, but you'll be able to book and then you're welcome to show up.
Wonderful. Yeah. And children welcome?
Yes, very welcome.
Dogs welcome?
No dogs because of the wildlife impacts.
Yeah, of course. At the moment. Yeah, so that's understandable.
We're monitoring, but we are very welcoming to kids, families. And we're hoping that we even have mobility scooters around and all of that. So we're hoping it's good for mobility too.
Now, there's one thing I'd like to just address with you. I grew up in and around Carey. Carey Woods were a playground as a children. And I can remember coming up here as a child, perhaps for different reasons than Ted came up here as a child.
Yeah.
But stumbling across, in effect, a miniature village.
Yeah.
Well, I'd say like three or four miniature houses with a mill attached to it. And I am convinced they are somewhere in those woods. Have you stumbled across them yourself?
I haven't found a miniature village, so I do wonder quite what you're up to in there. But there is potentially something that fits that description in some way. And it is related to a mill, to an old
water
mill. So, yeah, I mean, it may be something we can reveal at a later date. But yeah.
Ooh, the plot thickens, Ian, does it not?
Indeed.
Well, thank you very much indeed, Simon. It's been a pleasure to meet you, and it's been a pleasure to see the secret gardens. I'm going to, Ian, if I may, take a little stroll round, and hopefully technology won't let us down, just to show you, to give the viewers an idea of what delights that await you.
It's lovely, Mark. It looks lovely.
It's absolutely beautiful. And you can see there's a variety. There's a herb and tea garden, cut flowers, food forest, a stumpery. Which sounds interesting. Yes, the mind boggles. And there's the secret salt pit.
That's beautiful.
Just look how beautiful it is. I don't know if you can hear the birds singing as well.
Absolutely.
It's a very tranquil place. Very tranquil indeed.
And that's the sculpture there by our friend Ted?
It is. By our friend Ted. As I say, I spoke to him last night. We had quite an in-depth discussion about it. And it's a wonderful, wonderful sculpture, I have to say. Now, he did tell me, in fact, did Ted, that, as you heard, Simon has a background with Lush.
Right.
And the original plan was it was going to be like a bath bomb. But Ted decided that was too plain and round. So we made it more elliptical, I think was his words. I'd call it rugby ball shaped, but Ted knows his stuff, unlike me. And there we have it.
Fantastic.
Fantastic place. And I'm sure you can hear the birds singing in the background. Absolutely wonderful.
Mark, it looks really lovely there. And so being secret, it's just in Carey. You don't know the location. They give you the location when you book.
Well, I know the location here. But I can't divulge that, I'm afraid. You've got a book, and then you'll receive a secret package giving you the location. It's a bit like Mission Impossible. And if you choose to accept the invitation, then the message will self-destruct after 5 seconds.
I think that's a great way to go. Mark, listen, thank you very much indeed. Fascinating as always. Thanks very much for today, Mark, and we'll see you on the next one.
Brilliant. Look forward to seeing you all again. Take care.
Thanks,
now.
Mark.
Bye-bye.
Wow. That's not a secret garden in Carey. It's not really what it's known for, is it? But, well, I tell you what, let's see, because we've still got the same issues. We still have all of the same issues as we had before that. So we're going to try something different now. I'm going to see if I can do a few things just to see if I can get the lovely Ryan back over in America. He's still a blue screen as well. So we shall just have a look. I can hear him, I think. Ryan, are you there?
I am.
Excellent. And, I can hear. Oh, and you've turned into a very small person again. So bear with me a second. Technology. Technology's fantastic. Hello, Ryan. How are you, my friend?
I'm good. I'm enjoying the serenity of this place. The peace and quiet, in spite of the fact that we're in one of the busiest cities in the world. And surrounded by construction, but you can hear in the background, I think, the hiss of the water falling into the pond, or the pool, as I should say. I know it's been a very long show today. The security people have warned me not to engage with other people, or they will come and physically throw me out. So I will keep it short today.
Is that what they said?
Literally, yeah. So what I'm going to do, one of the things I wanted to show the viewers back home is that there's somebody, unfortunately, lost their life in the North Tower, which is the tower I'm next to, what's left of it. And his brother, I've been in touch with, and I know him very well. He's enjoyed his hospitality. And strangely enough, small world as it is, it even turned out that he'd worked with one of my cousins in the past. So very, very small world.
Very small.
And he's entertained us royally. So very grateful for that. So I'd like to pay tribute. And I'm just going to turn the camera around so you can see the name inscribed here, Richard Joseph Cadena. That's his brother. Fortunately, as I say, perished when the North Tower came down. Very, very sad. Complete, utter waste of life. But it's brought to my mind the recent video we saw, I don't know if you've seen it on Facebook, of Henry Searle singing Who Wants to Live Forever. And fair enough, none of us get to live forever. But I'll tell you what, some of us have the names that will live forever. And a memorial like this enables that to happen. And I think that's tremendous for the families to know that people will come here, strangers, everybody, tourists, some people will be taking smiling selfies, but at the end of the day, they are paying tribute to those that have lost their lives.
Yeah, absolutely right, Ryan. Absolutely right. I've spoken to a couple of people today that know the Cadenas. Tony Smith popped in today from the Ship of Doom, you know, says his regards to you, Ryan. And it was looking forward to today to see what he could see there.
Well, I wish I had a bigger camera with a wider lens than I, you know, and more time to walk around. And if you've never been to this site, I recommend it. As you can see, let's just put the camera forward again. Tourism is starting. All of this area was closed off for months, as you can imagine.
Yeah.
Because it was classed as the spreader area. Which is a bit ridiculous, but anyway, now we're starting to see people turn up. I was talking to a couple from Oklahoma come all the way, and this is one of the first places they came to see, to pay their respects. And having the trees around, you can imagine it gets very hot in this city in the summer, and that provides a tremendous amount of shade and just adds to the tranquility of the place. Really beautiful. Over here, I don't know if you can see it, this is the entrance to the main museum dedicated to the 9/11 tragedy. And you can pay to go in there. If you have a family member that lost their life here, you can get in for free. So a lot of changes in this area, you can imagine, as a result of such devastation and destruction. But just up the street, I can't see it. A month or so ago, before the trees got their leaves, you'll be able to see it. But there's the oldest permanently in-use public building, which is St. Paul's Chapel, in use since 1766. A little bit of a factoid there. And that's before, of course, the founding of this country. And, you know, so that was when it was under British rule. So, not much, I'm afraid, to say in terms of interviewing people today. A few people that I spoke to didn't want to be on camera anyway. So, having said that, I think it's just a wonderful place. Come here if you can, and if not, let me know. I can even send photographs if anybody wants any.
Yeah, fantastic.
So
Ryan,
I'll hand back to you.
Ryan, listen, that was fantastic. What a, like you say, what a tranquil place, and what a place to reflect and go and pay the respects. Fantastic. Really, really interesting, Ryan. Listen, thank you for bringing that to us, matey. It's, you know, it affected a lot of people. It's probably still raw for a lot of people watching who are involved. But thanks for bringing it to us, Ryan. I think it was the right thing to do. It's a lovely place there. And we'll definitely catch you on the next show.
Absolutely.
Ryan, thank you very much indeed. Take care. And you, matey. Wow, that's a place, isn't it? That's a nice place to go if you want a bit of peace and tranquility and to pay your respects. Yes, look very nice there. Now, the last but not least, let's go straight away to the wonderful Mr. Gary. Gary, hello, sir. How are you?
Hello, Ian.
Yay!
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you, see you, and everything. Everything is good.
It's been a mad night tonight. Obviously,
it has. That's fine, Gary. That angle is perfect, mate.
Okay. I'm going to rush on because it is a quarter past seven.
Thank you, Gary. That's all right. But what have you got? It's cod in parsley sauce, isn't it?
It is cod in wine and parsley sauce. Yeah.
Ooh,
I'm going to add the wine very shortly. These are two nice pieces of cod.
Beautiful.
Compliments from the Sea Breeze
restaurant.
Right on the beach. You know, that one.
Lovely job, Sea Breeze restaurant and fish and chips, all of that bit. Beautiful. Thank you very much indeed.
So what I'm going to do is, right, so we're going to start with 21 grams of butter.
Okay? Lovely.
Okay. I know you've been running over time, but technology's not my fault. You know?
No, that's all right. You keep going, matey. You carry on.
But the producer did put the blame down to me. I was seconds away, you know? Unbelievable. We'll carry on. We shall continue. Right. So we're going to wait for that to melt a little bit. When it doesn't eventually melt. What I want to do is to promote... Sea Breeze actually is they say to me, tell everyone to come and enjoy a drink in a newly refurbished bar, and you can go in for a drink. You don't need the food, you can go in for a drink whenever you want. They're open from 9 a.m.
What, for a drink?
I'm guessing so. I'm
on there, so, mate.
Yeah. But also while we're there, they're looking for takeaway staff, waiting staff, and shopkeepers for this season. So if you want to pop down there, or even give them a call on 426-222, should I say.
Probably better off looking online, Gary, now, aren't they?
I don't know. Technology's rubbish. It doesn't ever work.
Yeah, it is today.
As we know.
Yeah, I can imagine they'll be incredibly busy for the summer, Gary, being right on that seafront. It must be a crazy time for them.
Yeah, yeah. They always get they did. Especially Carnival week.
Yes.
You know, normally that would pull a crowd in right on the beach there. So what we're doing, it's 21 grams of butter.
Lovely.
And 21 grams of plain flour, okay?
Okay.
This is gonna be the base of the sauce.
Okay.
I've got because you told me about 10 minutes again. I've got the potato and the peas ready.
Are you happy? Excellent. With that? Well, you've already had 25 minutes.
What we're gonna do? my voice is going actually. There'll be no singing tonight. I'll turn it down slightly. Open the window before we start, shall we?
Fire.
Right, the window's now open. So what we want to do, 21 grams, we want to pop it into the pan slowly mixing it around with a whisk, okay?
Okay.
And it will, eventually.
Ooh.
It will turn into like a doughy paste.
Right. Okay.
You can see that.
Yep.
It'll be a totally doughy paste. Then you get your milk before it burns. Right, back in there. So you need...
How much milk are you putting in?
You need a pint of milk in that.
Right.
I'm going to turn it up a bit. Oh, you only give him what, 10 minutes. It is about a 10-minute dish, actually, to be honest. It's, normally takes about 10 minutes.
That's
so you've got to whisk it quite vigorously, yeah?
Right.
He said. Normally I do it in a saucepan, but just so you can see how I'm going to roll it.
Well, very nice, Gary. Yes, very nice.
Yeah.
So what are you doing then? What sort of consistency do you need to stir that to?
You know, You know what I'm going to say, didn't you?
Don't say it. If I think something's crossing your mind like that, Gary, no, do never say things like that. But I understand it needs to be like a pasty type, does it?
Yeah. No. Now it needs to be, I'll add a bit more milk on that. It needs to be actually, until the lumps are gone, it needs to be thin. Between thin and lumpy.
Between thin and medium, let's say. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. So in a minute, right, I'm going to add a bit of salt to this as well.
Okay.
Add a drop of salt to that.
Lovely.
Okay, we're going to go for that. And obviously the main ingredient is half a glass of wine.
Lovely.
And obviously, cheers.
Cheers for the other glass, yeah. Cheers for the other half, lovely.
I do like that bit. I love that bit.
I think all cooks love that bit, Gary. Okay, what's happening?
It won't be lumpy. The mistake people make, actually, is that they put too much flour in, or, too much of the flour and butter, and it doesn't turn into like a sauce. But this is getting to be a sauce.
Oh, looks good. Looks good.
I've only had two fails in these shows, so I'm doing well. Right.
You do great, Gary. Don't you worry.
I'm cutting James and Christina Wright's cod into four pieces. Very nice cod it is.
It looks really sumptuous, that cod, doesn't it?
Beautiful, beautiful cod. Okay, we're going to cook that. I'm going to add a bit more wine, to be honest. It'd be lovely.
Hey!
I need to refill my glass.
And how long do you cook that bit for, Gary? Do you just keep bring it up, not to the boil, obviously, you just keep getting the lumps out, I'm assuming.
If it starts to boil, you've got to bring it down to a medium heat, okay?
Okay.
So we're going to cook away.
Lovely. And I'm assuming the fish is now absorbing all of that juice.
That's right. No, well, the fish is basically... whatever juices there are from the fish is going into the dish.
Lovely.
Yeah, Rob. Previous to this, I have boiled it, and so basically all the goodness has gone in the boiling of it, and then you pop it into there. But I'm trying. This is actually the first time I'm trying this one to do it in, especially a saucepan. A frying pan.
Yeah, it looks okay, mate. Let's have a look what we're looking at.
Right. Basically, you're poaching it, really.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Okay.
And it takes about... sorry about this, Ian. It takes about 10 minutes to poach it.
Yeah. It looks like it's done, though. So let's do it as if it's done.
No. We can't do that. Just give it time.
Okay. We don't have that. But that's okay.
How long have you got?
You've got about 2 minutes.
Really?
Yeah, really. You got 2 minutes.
I've only just popped on the show. What's going on? No, hang in there. Right.
Lovely.
Anyway, this ferry business, yeah? I would say that if you think about on all of it, the 25p rise is non-negotiable, really. It's fine.
Well, it's negligible, Gary, but, you know, it's still an extra cost for people.
25 pence.
Yep.
Right.
People aren't happy about it. I don't know. Listen, people aren't happy about it. That's all I can say.
Right, how much? Did you want the engineers and all that to go on minimum wage then? Is that what it is? I don't know.
I have absolutely... I couldn't tell you, Gary. I don't know what the situation is with it there at all. I have absolutely no idea. But I'm sure we'll find out in the fullness of time. Right, Gary, how are you doing there? What's happening?
Right, I'm going to turn the cod, okay?
What into? Another fish?
Yeah, you know what? I'll tell you what, technology. I've lost part of the fish. Anyway, we're getting there. because you're rushing me, you know? This fish should not be rushed.
Okay.
Right. Meanwhile, I'll have a glass of wine.
Right, Gary, come on. Let's see it. Let's see it plated up.
Man.
Let's all see it plated up and looking lovely because it's making me hungry.
It's almost there, all right? Just chill. Just chill. Sit back and relax now. It's almost the end of the show.
Hmm.
I'm going to turn it up a little bit. It's doing well so far, to be honest.
I think that's it. It's got to be close, Gary, isn't it?
Right. It's almost there, all right? Right, it is.
I'm just wondering
there,
if we've got any viewers left and they've not all gone to get something to eat. You've made them starving. Ooh.
It normally takes up to 10 minutes anyway. But I'm not, I mean, I'm going to eat this in a minute and I will send some round to you.
Thank you.
And you won't be there.
Thank you. No, I'm waiting. I'm waiting. Don't worry. I'm waiting. We'll get someone around in a minute. That looks great.
It is almost there, okay?
And what are you serving it with, Gary?
It will be served, already done, is peas and mashed potato.
The classic.
It used to be actually, yeah, it did used to be a classic meal. But I've not actually seen it in pubs at all, anywhere, or anywhere at restaurant, really. You know, the old one, cod and parsley sauce, it used to be there.
Yeah, you don't see it in the pubs anymore. You're absolutely right.
Everyone's gone up market, I think. Slightly.
Beautiful.
Are you happy now? Right, I'm going to put some parsley across it. You can put as much as you want or as little as you want of parsley.
You like a lot, yeah?
In between small amount and a large amount.
Somewhere in between. Looks great though, mate.
It is getting there. It really is. Because you're letting me have a bit of time extra. I had trouble getting on the call, didn't I? God.
Well, technology's not working today, Gary. It's been a bit of a nightmare for us, but you know, when you're transatlantic, when you're, you know, broadcasting all across the world, it's very difficult sometimes.
All right, we are getting there now.
Come on then, let's see him. Let's see the finished product. The people are waiting, they're starving. People are saying, hurry up, Gary, feed us, feed us.
I don't want to get food poisoning, you nutter. What are you doing? Right, we'll leave it like that for a minute.
Ooh, let's have a look, mate. Oh, I can smell it, Gary. It's lovely.
Right.
Oh, Gary, that looks fantastic, mate. Oh, are you sure that's coming round to me in a minute? That is lovely.
Well, no, this one isn't. That one is.
Oh, right. Yeah. That was for you, is it? Oh, Gary, that is brilliant. That is cod in white wine and parsley sauce.
That's correct, yeah. Yeah, and thank you to James and Christina Wright of Seabreeze and right on the beach. Also say hi to Fonz. Everyone knows Fonz. He's part of the chippy down there.
Excellent. Excellent. So, Gary, do they serve that down in Seabreeze, do you know?
No, of course they don't.
Well, let's have a chat with them.
No one serves it. I haven't seen it for years, you know?
Gary, suggest it to them. It does look lovely, my friend. Really enjoy yourself, and I'm glad you're back with us. We'll sort it out for next time, mate. We'll get the technology better.
Hopefully, yeah. Right.
Gary,
this is cooked. Hopefully this is cooked.
Beautiful. If you're not on the next show, we'll know what happened.
Well, you won't be either, will you?
No, that's very true. Leave mine in for a bit longer. Gary, listen, thank you very much, my friend.
Thank you.
We'll see you on the next show, mate. Thanks, Gary.
You take care. Good night.
Wow, there you go. Cod in white wine and parsley sauce from Gary there. Thank you. It's really making me hungry. Just like to thank everyone. Thanks to all the crew. Mark, Nico, Ryan, and of course the housewife's favourite, Gary. Thank you to our guests, all of them from the Secret Garden in Carey, and of course the Grand Hotel. Super job, really enjoyed it. Thanks very much. We will see you on the next show. Thanks for joining us.